All right. Hey guys at home, if you're watching this part, this is just the pre-show. YouTube takes a few seconds to catch up and on these little impromptu streams, I want to make sure that everything's going before we get started, so nothing, you know, sort of goes awry. So just give me 2 seconds, and we'll get this thing started. Okay. All right, stream is good to go. We're going to start this thing off. What is up, Press Play fans? It is Saturday night, 11 o'clock, and I just got the urge. I mean, it's Steam sale time. The winter Steam sale is in effect. We are deep in the savings. And yeah, I picked up a game that I haven't thought about in a while, but sort of am remembering how great it is. And I wanted to share it with you guys. So that game is Far Cry 2, and I picked up the Fortunes Edition, sort of DLC inclusive version of the game for $5 on Steam. I believe, I'll actually just do a quick fact check here, I believe it's still available for, yep, for $5 with the DLC included. And yeah, I just want to sort of just play through it and, I don't know, show it off. So let's go here. Far Cry 2. Far Cry 2 is an unapologetically first-person experience. It is very dedicated to its idea of using first-person. You know, you don't have like a mini-map or anything of that sort. Uh-oh, about to run into a camp of guys, that was bad. Yeah, it's sort of a unique game because of how this guy, of how much it completely foregoes the traditional like video game conventions in a lot of ways. I mean, it was sort of a showpiece for its like simulational. I don't know. It has like these fire mechanics I can show off in a second, where you know if you have a flamethrower or something, you can. Yeah, I'm still in the beginning of the game, so it's giving me a... Oh, crap. Yeah, it did jam. That was one of the semi things that this game showed off. But yeah, also, when this thing starts working, once I punch it a few times... let's find out when it starts working. So you could, like, shoot fire into the grass, and it would start propagating, which was, like, a big thing for this game that sort of... It started a lot of, it set a lot of things in motion, I think. I mean, Far Cry 3 has a mechanic that's sort of similar to this, idea. And I don't know, a couple more games, still jammed. A couple more games, did stuff like this. But I think Far Cry 2 was sort of the first and best, sort of version of this idea. Yeah, I mean, it's an open world. You can change the map here. Where is it? The big one, yeah. So this is like sort of the larger areas. And yeah, you just drive around and liberate guard posts and I don't know, you go to the bar to get like new missions or new guns. Your guns jam on you. You also could, I don't know, there's a bunch of different things. We'll go through it and I'll talk about it instead of sort of just telling you what's up. So yeah, right now we're trying to get to a mission where I think there's some, basically you have a best friend in this game, which is sort of randomly generated from a series of possible guys. Is this guy bad or good? And, oh, he's bad. And every time you do a mission for like a faction in this game, you can sort of, your best friend can give you optional objectives as well. So I'm trying to meet somebody to achieve a optional goal in one of the first missions of the game. Let's take some water. And some ammo. All right. So I bought this, whatever gun this is, this little assault rifle here, so it shouldn't... I believe if you buy guns in Far Cry 2, they won't jam, and they'll be kept in perfect condition, but if you... I think if you pick up the equivalent gun, it is not, you know, it's not always going to be an unjammable gun. I think it's only if you take it from, like, your weapon cache or whatever. Uh-oh. Or flamethrower, sort of my last resort weapon. Oh crap! I went down. I sort of forget, you know, as I was going through this game, I kind of forgot how weirdly difficult it can be sometimes. So you really need to sort of think about what you're doing, which is not. I mean, you know, it happens a little bit in games, but Far Cry 2 takes it to an interesting direction, like where when you go down, you can see one of my friends here is actually helping me back up, and I think they can get killed trying to help you, which is really kind of makes you feel bad when it actually happens. Oh, that's right. So you have like history with a person, so I guess when you do more missions with them, they'll be more inclined to help you or better friends with you. I don't really remember how that stuff works. What am I even doing here? I'm trying to like. I don't know. I think I'm trying to meet somebody, but I don't know why there's all these bad guys around. Crap. These guys sometimes have laser focus on you, even through foliage, which is kind of a bummer. I forget how to throw grenades. Maybe it's G or... I gotta check that. Oh crap! That's how I do it. Cute. I can't remember how to, maybe E is throw fire grenade. You can do a Molotov cocktail as well. But I don't recall how to do it. It's probably dangerous to just start pressing buttons in this game. Trying to get over here. If you got questions in the chat or comments, tell me how bad I am at Far Cry 2. I'm sure I am pretty terrible. Yeah, make sure to leave them in the YouTube comments. They essentially act the same as a Twitch chat or any sort of, you know, live updating chat service. So yeah, feel free.
What? We can work this out, whatever it is.
What am I supposed to do? Kill this guy?
Okay.
Bravo Papa Mike, this is Charlie 2-4. Do you read?
We copy, go ahead.
Stand by for coordinates.
Roger that.
Alright. So, alright, we go down there. Oh, okay, so I think this is the, I wonder if I can kill this guy. Maybe I shouldn't. I think we're trying to, like, reroute some trucks. And what's interesting is because, you know, there's multiple ways to go about these missions. You could do this one where you just do what the original quest giver tells you, and you would sort of attack these guys out in the open, but instead, I believe what I'm trying to do here is... sort of reroute these this convoy so that they will be more of like a close quarters combat scenario, which is, I think it's really interesting. I mean, you know, this game did a lot of stuff with sort of, I guess, branching paths of possible things, like in terms of, you know, your friends could actually get killed and be replaced by other friends and stuff, and, you know, some of this stuff with different ways you can do missions and everything was kind of interesting. Somebody's shooting at me, but I'm not even going to worry about it. Man, can this car go any slower in reverse? And yeah, I mean, Far Cry 2, man, it's in an African setting, which is pretty awesome. I mean, the first Far Cry, which was, you know, sort of a Crytek tech demo-y joint, was obviously on that, like, island setting. No. Not much sound effects on that machete there. Yeah, the first Far Cry was in that, like, island setting, which obviously looked beautiful, but it was pretty cool when Crytek went away and Ubisoft was sort of left with the Far Cry franchise, that they made a spiritual successor instead of a, you know, sort of direct sequel, like, well, I guess they did make the Far Cry, you know, the magic powers weird game that they made, but after that, I mean, you know, to do the named sequel in a completely different direction is a pretty brave move, and I don't know if I can say that it actually worked out that well for them, because I think it didn't do that well, Far Cry 2, but I mean, as far as reviewers go and as far as I'm concerned, I really respect that move that they made, and I hope that more games will sort of follow in the footsteps of this game. I mean, I guess you could say this, the System Shock series is doing the same thing, even though they, you know, they're not directly naming their games as sequels, but, you know, BioShock was essentially a remake of System Shock in another setting, and BioShock Infinite was BioShock in another setting, essentially. Yeah, I mean, that's just always a unique idea. Uh-oh. Oh, crap, I really hurt myself there. Far Cry 2 also had the pretty cool, like, if your health goes down below one bar, you would do, like, a really, really uncomfortably realistic animation to, like, you know, take a bullet out of your body or snap your arm back in place, I think. And it was pretty gruesome, but it really got you into the feel. What do I prefer, Far Cry 1, 2, or 3? In terms of the game I actually played the most, I'd probably say 3 was the one that I really, I guess, got into the most. Thanks for the question, by the way, Jesse J. But yeah, I mean, I always respected Far Cry 2. When I played it, I didn't have the best PC, so I couldn't really get that far into the game without, you know, becoming sort of a slideshow weird thing, but this game had so many good, really awesome ideas, and I'm interested to go back into it now that, you know, I have a PC from 2013 that's actually worth its salt, and, yeah, I mean, it just runs like a dream now, so you can just enjoy the game for what it really is. Uh-oh. I feel like the AI is a little lacking sometimes, but then at the same time, uh-oh, it'll surprise you and be sort of, like, super intelligent sometimes, so, uh-oh. Is the game freezing, or what's going on? Uh-oh. I think we lost our game. Alright. Apologies, guys. I didn't realize that this game was prone to crashing, but I suppose I should have expected it. Let's see how much progress we lost. I think I had just saved right before the show, so I assume I can just go right back to this spot. Yeah, that's a pretty big bummer. I do apologize for that. Where do you want Far Cry to be next? Kenny Turner, thanks for the question. I don't know. I think Crysis was kind of a cool direction to bring it, which was, you know, they had the, it was sort of fake Far Cry remake at the beginning where it's on the island and everything, but then, you know, they sort of changed it into, like, the snow setting with science fiction stuff. I would like to see a Far Cry game, I guess. Man, I don't know. It's a good question. It would have to have some of that sort of... Oh yeah, this is where we started the show, I guess, so let's try and power through this. Whoops. It would have to be something that has, like, that dynamic feel. You know, Far Cry series, whether it's Crysis or the original Far Cry or any of these games, what really sets them apart, what's, like, the connective tissue is, you know, its attempt to really be, like, a sort of, I guess, just simulation, like a, you know, an island simulation. Like, a lot of these, you know, aspects where it's propagating fire, or in Crysis where it would do all these, like, hyper-realistic things with, like, animals on the island, and, you know, the grass moves with you, and you knock down a tree by shooting in a line where the tree would sort of break apart. Like, there's all these weird things. And, yeah, I guess whatever they do next would have to be something that sort of captured that idea. I'm not really sure what that would be. What do you guys think? I mean, in the comments, let me know where you would like to see the Far Cry series go. Alright, so let's try and siege this thing without getting killed this time. Oops, guys. These guys are really good at flanking in this game. I have been surprised a few times, even in the short amount of time I've been playing it recently, to sort of find them just pretty efficiently going around and catching me off guard. I'm interested to know if you guys, you know, which Far Cry games you guys like, or, you know, if you are fans of the series. And I don't know, man, I haven't met a lot of people who really hold this game in high regard, but, you know, I had always seen good reviews of it, and of course when I played it I thought it was really cool. And yeah, I mean, I don't know, let me know if you guys have any love for Far Cry 2. Oh, crap, man. Yeah, the thing about, I guess, this game is, like, ammo can become in very short supply very fast, and I should probably be, even though I bought that gun, I should probably have just switched it out for something else. Kenny Turner, you want to see Far Cry in space? Yeah, that would be pretty cool. I mean, Crysis sort of did that, I guess, where the space came to you, I suppose. It was like an alien invasion concept. But I'd love to see it go into space. And, I mean, the simulation stuff could go pretty far. There's one of those gruesome things, but it was a little messed up. You could do a lot with the simulation in terms of, you know, simulating, like, how you float around in space, or how you would... How you would get around a space station or something like that. Like, it could actually be pretty interesting. Oh, wow, you can break these shelves here. Alright, let's see if there's any guns I can take. Where'd that guy go that we just killed? She's not too smart, I guess. I think he was around here. Yeah. Alright, let's take this guy's gun. What's cool about this game, too, is, you know, there's not really, as far as I know, there was never a meter that would say, like, how much strength your gun had left in it. It was just a visual thing. So, you know, you'd pick up a gun, and it would, you could see the wear on the gun. I'm trying to illustrate this, but all these guns are pretty well taken care of. Let's see if the shotgun's any better. But yeah, you could just tell sort of by how rusty it became, or how messed up it just looked. Yeah, you can see this shotgun's really messed up. Let's try and... I don't know if I can jam it straight out, but... Let's go back up to this house, see if we can... Oh, maybe there's a back entrance. I wonder where these guys are coming from. And this game also had the, pretty weird mechanic of, having your guy have malaria, which... I can't remember if they actually made you keep going back and getting medicine, but... There are certain points where, you know, your screen will actually go blurry because you're dying of a disease, which, you know, you gotta appreciate the balls that they had to really sort of go all out with some of these really sort of not marketable concepts. get back up here and do what we were doing. I am just gonna save, just to be sure.
What? We can work this up, whatever it is. Okay, okay.
So Steam sale's been going on for a couple of days. I've been doing my duty in voting for which games go on sale when I could, because I really want those cards, man. And yeah, I didn't really pick up a lot. I mean, I picked up this. I got... oh, man. I'm blanking on what I actually ended up grabbing. But I got a couple of things for really cheap. But yeah, I'm sure that... you know, there's a lot of games out there for people who haven't been playing a lot this year. I mean, there's some great stuff that's been on sale. I think Bioshock Infinite's on sale for like $10 or something like that, which is insane. That game's awesome.
All systems go. SF team is headed for the Shantytown now.
Yeah, I mean, if you guys have been picking anything up on Steam, let me know. I'd love to hear what you guys have been playing. Alright, so we need to go this way. What I love about this game too is, like, if you're sprinting, you actually just can't see your map. Like, you have to stop, just sort of stop moving. Like, even if you're walking like this, other than on this GPS thing here, the map, like, if you're trying to look at the bottom, you have to stop to look at it. Like, there's no other way to see it, as far as I knew. And yeah, it's just weird things like that make this game feel really brave. Let's go. I think there's a guy over there. Or is that my guy? That's my guy. Alright, so we are going. Oh. It's hard to hold a map and drive at the same time, apparently. Oh man, I am doing an Austin Powers right now. Boom. Yeah. So I don't know what these things are. I forget. These are like satellite dishes or something. Let's see what's out here. So I am right next to one, apparently. Oh. So what am I supposed to do with these? I might have to, get a mission to do this or something. I haven't played this game in a long time. I mean, we're not, you know, this is a Just Because live stream for anybody who doesn't, isn't familiar with the concept. It's when we do sort of more impromptu, you know, we just want to show off a game that we think is really cool. It's not really a formal thing. It doesn't have to be, obviously, this is not a new game by any stretch. And yeah, I mean, I just wanted to show off Far Cry 2. I think it's an awesome game. I'd love to hear what you guys think of it or any stories you guys have from it. And yeah, I'm just going to be sharing my sort of experience going through it for a little bit. I'd love to do more of these, especially around Steam sale time. If there's anything you guys want me to show off, definitely let me know and I'll try to either get it in the Steam sale or, if I already have it, show it. Where are these guys? And yeah, I mean, we're not doing a Steampunks this week, so I figure doing a couple of these just because streams when I can fit it in could be pretty fun. Ah. Crap. I think you could upgrade your health abilities, or the, you know, sort of how many pips you have and all that stuff, because I don't remember losing health quite this fast when I originally played it. Where am I going?
Where'd he go?
He's here somewhere.
Quick, use the
Some really good use of, you know, they're not quite as advanced as they would be now, but just the physics in this game were pretty pervasive and pretty well implemented. I mean, there was a lot of objects in the game that sort of used the physics system, and it just all reacted in a really nice manner. You saw before where I threw a grenade inside the house and it like actually blew up a bunch of the things in there. I mean, that was really impressive when this game, what was it, like 2008, 2009? Died again. Apparently my friend didn't want to help me out that time. Oh, jeez. We're back at this. Wow. Okay, I need to be more careful this time. I apologize, guys, making you watch this more than, what is it, three times now? This game is pretty great, though. If you listen to podcasts, if you're inclined to listen to podcasts, definitely check out Steve Gaynor's Tone Control, where he actually interviewed Clint Hawking, who was like the project lead on this game, I believe. And he has some really great stories about sort of putting this game together. That's what kind of got me interested again in playing this game, was listening to that show. Yeah, it's just a really great sort of, it's probably like an hour and a half long, just really going at it with some pretty in-depth stuff. I mean, if you guys know Steve Gaynor, he did Gone Home, he did Bioshock 2, Minerva's Den. He's pretty celebrated in like the game design space, and his podcast is sort of it's from the angle of game designers talking to other game designers about their craft, and it's really in-depth, really intelligent. That's worth listening to. Be a red objective around here, which I'm not. I guess it all sort of converged on one, maybe, but yeah, I guess can't really do that. Let's go liberate a safe house. I don't think I got very far at all in the actual missions of this game, because all I would ever do is run around and try to blow things up and set fire to everything and do all the side quests, which, you know, tends to happen in open world games for me. I'm sure with a lot of other people as well. It's just wreak havoc here. Love it. Alright. And get out of there. The best thing about this is you could sort of just set fire to a place and just completely run away and wait for destruction to take over, where, you know, you could sort of smoke guys out, you could get them to come to you. The strategies that started emerging from this gameplay were really interesting. And yeah, I'm trying to get back into the Far Cry 2 headspace. You could tell that I sort of am not completely there yet. This was a pretty cool mechanic as well. When you go into your safe houses that you liberate, you could actually set your watch to change the time of day. So it's like 10 o'clock at night now. We can maybe go to like, I guess the sun, like 6 o'clock. And, you know, you could approach a scenario from a completely different, like, you know, time of day very easily. So yeah, now it's light out. Probably would have been better to storm that thing with, you know, under the cover of darkness, but I don't know that the AI has any trouble in darkness, but I definitely do, so make it a little easier to see. This game just did some great stuff with, I don't know what you call this fog, like volumetric fog or something, but, you know, in terms of perspective, having all the stuff falling away from you be, you know, sort of obscured and everything, it looks absolutely fantastic. Oh man, I think I lost my car somewhere around here. And I don't think I'm gonna find it. Oh, here it is. Nice. What's the camouflage like the DeLorean in Back to the Future? Find some leaves. Guys could take some bullets. There's always a thing about this game is I think they can take more bullets than you can sometimes. Let's grab this thing. It's not quite like in Crysis where you can shoot the gun straight from the driver's side, but you can definitely how do you do it? I think you hit crouch or C. Just jump right in here. I wonder if you can knock down trees in this. Probably. It's a later game thing, I guess. Uh-oh. I'm attracting some unwanted attention. Oh, crap. I messed up my car. This was cool about Far Cry 2 as well, which, you know, if you mess up your car, you can actually, assuming that you're in a safe enough spot, which I probably am not, you could just repair it. At any time, and I mean, I don't know, it's a unique game. It really is. What is this, a shotgun? I don't like to keep shotguns unless I have. I think you can get semi-autos or automatic pistol type things, since you can only have, you know, the way they gate your weapon holding is like you can have a. Small arm, small gun, or whatever. You can have a medium gun and a big gun. And yeah, I don't like to make my medium, you know, normal gun, sort of short range gun like that. Unless I have to. Alright, so let's. Number one, let's save. I'm gonna do some more saving. I should probably get into the habit of saving this more often. But hopefully I won't die again, because that doesn't make for very good internet television. Hold on, guys. I'm actually going to check something on the stream real quick. All right. Stream is doing fine. Let me know if you're having any sort of, you know, frame rate issues or anything like that. I mean, on my end, it's all looking fine, but, you know, it can be kind of hard for me when I'm playing, since I'm controlling this one by myself, to sort of see if, you know, if there's any sort of video issues happening. Alright, so I wanted to go to that safe house, but I guess I can still do that. Let's try and find it here. It's gotta be that way. Oh, it might be on top of a mountain or something. Let's see if there's. Yeah, it's gotta be up there, right? I don't think I'm gonna get up there. Well, let's try to storm this thing. What is my objective right now? Destroy the commando's gear. So, what this guy was telling me. This quest giver guy was that if I did what he said, which we did do, then it would be a lot sort of more simple because it's sort of close quarters combat versus the more like head on, more difficult attack. Oh crap! These guys are shooting something at me. And, yeah, now we're in the middle of, like, a firestorm. Let's try and get out of here. Crap. Got It's really tough in this game because you can't run while you reload, and you really need to do a lot of running in this one, so it becomes sort of hard to, to get through some of these combat encounters. Crap. Yeah, you can see a lot of flanking going on here. Some breathing room. Alright, let's make him come to us. I think we got that guy. I'm really just sort of pixel hunting now. I'm running out of syringes. I'm sort of fearing for my video game life a little bit, but we are short on all ammo. I think we just found a jam too. Yeah, this is the type of scenario you can find yourself in Far Cry 2, which is all guns non-functional at once, and most of the time at a really inopportune moment. And then once your gun starts jamming, it'll only ever really get worse, so this is not gonna go too well for us unless we find a new gun. Don't go in the fire. Ah, crap. I think I did get hit by fire a little bit. Alright, so this should have some ammo. Yep. Okay. Find a new handgun. Oh, hold on. 8 bullets. Alright. Now our little better equipped. I am not picking up ammo for this. Oh yeah, I am. You could also use your map to sort of scout things out, so you'd actually hold the right mouse button while you had the map out, and you can sort of mark things, and then it'll tell you. Oh, come on. Yeah, game crashed again. It must be pretty unstable. I mean, I was having a bit of an issue with DirectX 10 compatibility. People were sort of jumping up and down all the time while I was just walking around the world. And yeah, I guess there must be some kind of, I don't know, crash bug. I didn't encounter that before we started streaming, but maybe there's something about using XSplit with this game. I'm not going to jump back into it. Far Cry 2 is an awesome game. If that stuff gets figured out, if I can figure out that crash issue, I will do another stream. But yeah, I don't know if I want to make you guys sit through me doing the same stuff again. But yeah, Far Cry 2 is a great game. You can find it on Steam in this winter sale for $5, and it includes the DLC. I'm sure it won't crash as much for you if you're not streaming. It didn't for me. So yeah, I mean, look forward to more Just Because live streams. If I can find the time to sort of do these, I won't be as terrible at the games that I do, unless it's Far Cry 2 again. And it likely will not crash. If you want to see more stuff we did, you can click on any of these three windows here. Top right, you can see our Game of the Year stuff. We just finished up 5 days of releasing articles. I think there was like 35 or so categories that we ended up selecting things in, so you know all your favorite games are sure to be represented there, and make sure to let us know what your picks would be for Game of the Year as well. Bottom right is our coverage of the Xbox One launch event. You can see me and Pete Kendall from How Do I Jump there, and on the left is our most recent Steampunks on The Walking Dead, the new season of The Walking Dead game, and it's really good. Make sure to subscribe on YouTube and find us on social media, and those links you can see up on the top. And PressPlayTV.com is going to be where you can find all of our most recent stuff, including that Game of the Year award ceremony. So, until next time, guys. Thanks for watching. Sorry about the the deaths and crashes, but we will have this solved next time. And, until next time.